I killed your real mother. I shot her in the face, just like those papers say. You had to have known something was off after all these years, deep inside. I raised you as my own, ever since Lula had you. It's a miracle you came out as healthy as you did. Your mother was in no condition to raise a baby. She had no one else but me. And we were closer than sisters. I promised her I'd do my best to raise you as my own, on her behalf. She'd recover from drugs, relapse, recover, relapse. This went on forever. And then I met and fell in love with a woman named Diamond. And she was a diamond, all right. She could shine as bright as the sun, but hurt you real bad. If you stare too long. Somewhere along the way, Lula must have gotten jealous. Or somehow or another, Lula and Diamond became a thing. I was betrayed. Destroyed. And well, I tied Diamond up to a rowboat, rowed her out into the swamp, shot a few holes into the boat, and watched it sink. With Diamond's shiny eyes staring back at me, the entire time. I waited till she drowned. I rowed back out of the darkness in a different rowboat, of course. I wasn't so sure what to do about Lula, but her drugging got out of control. And I think the last straw was when she threatened me, saying she was going to go to the police in order to take you away from me. She was planning on selling you for drug money. I had a decision to make, didn't I? I made up a bank robbery job that we could pull together. I promised her the money, all the money in the world, and it would help us get back on track. I thought long and hard as to what I was going to do that day. And the final verdict in my mind was I was going to take down Lula. And so that's what I did.
One year before, couldn't look you in the eye. You're just like an angel. Your skin makes me cry. You flow like a feather in a beautiful world. I wish I was special. You're so very special. But I'm a creep, and I'm a widow. What the am I doing here? I don't belong. When I have control, I want a perfect body. I want a perfect soul. I want you to notice when I'm not around. I wish I was special. You're so very special. But I'm a creep, and I'm a widow. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. She's running out the door. She's running. She run, 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 run. Whatever makes you happy. Whatever you want. You're so very special. I wish I was special. But I'm a creep, and I'm a widow. What the hell am I doing?
Just mount up the entire lobby. Sorry, we don't deal with your kind here. No one does. No one here would be willing to touch someone with your blood type. B, I assume? About a stench. B negative? That's even worse. O is a delicacy. That's what vampires crave the most. A is good. A fine blood type we can all enjoy. AB is tolerable. It's mixed with B, but A is strong enough to make it drinkable. But B is the absolute worst. B positive is bad enough. It smells like a skunk peeling onions in a sewage processing plant. But B negative has such a rare and terrific smell. I can't even begin to imagine what it would taste like. Surely disgusting. I'm positive.
I sense there's something in the wind that feels like tragedy's at hand. And though I'd like to stand by him, can't shake this feeling that I have. The worst is just around the bend. And does he notice my feelings for him? And will he see how much he means to me? I think it's not to be. What will become of my dear friend? Where will his actions lead us then? Although I'd like to join the crowd in their enthusiastic cloud, try as I may, it doesn't last. And end up together. No, I think not. It's never to become, for I am not the one.
Everybody thinks my sister is perfect. It just makes me want to choke a toad. All dressed all nice, like a big puff of cotton candy. As if sugar could melt in the little rosebud throat. Well, duh, of course she looks all sweet and nice. She's dressed all girly from her head to her toe. Nobody thinks evil could reside in all that fluff. It just proves that she's mom and dad's favorite. And what do they give me to wear? Black, black, and oh wait. More black. How's someone supposed to look good in that? I mean, of course I'm a bit grouchy at times. Do you know how hot it gets wearing black all summer long? But of course she's all smiles and cute little songs and her perky little voice. I mean, let her wear this get up for a while and we'll see how she feels. But not Glinda. Oh no, she's the good witch. So what does that make me? The bad one, of course. What a joke. I mean, I just turned one little guy into a scarecrow and suddenly I'm wicked? It's just not fair. She gets away with everything. It just makes me so mad that I just have to step through him. Now doesn't that feel much better?
It was strange the way it happened. One of those quirks of fate, really. One of those moments when you seem irredeemably lost. You panic. You're trapped. You're back against a wall. And then it happens. You get a break. All the pieces seem to fit into place. What a sucker you'd been. What a fool. It took only a small accident to make it happen. An accident. That's how I discovered the secret. That elusive ingredient, that spark that is the breath of life. You see, Brad and Janet, you are fortunate, for tonight is the night my beautiful creature is destined to be born. Throw open the switches on the sonic escalator and turn up the power reactor input 3 more notches.
Don't you disrespect me, little man. Don't you derogate me or derive. You're in my world now, not your world. And I got friends on the other side. Hear that echo, gentlemen? It's a little something we have in Louisiana. A little parlor trick, don't worry. Sit down at my table, put your mind at ease. If you sit down, it will enable me to do anything I please. Yeah, I can read your future. I can change it around since you. I look deep into your heart and soul. You do have a soul, don't you, Lawrence? make your wildest dreams come true. I got voodoo, I got voodoo, I got things I ain't even tried. And I got friends on the other side. The cards will tell. The past, the present, and the future as well. The cards, just take three. Take a little trip into your future with me. Now you young men are from across the sea. You come from two long lines of royalty. I'm with myself, I'm on the other side. Your lifestyle's high, but your fun's all low. You got a merry little honey whose daddy got dough. Mom and dad cut you off, old playboy. Now y'all gotta get hitched. But hitching ties you down. You just wanna be free, hop from place to place. But freedom takes green. It's the green you'll need. And when I look into the future, it's the green that I see. Honey, you little man, I don't want to waste much time. You've been pushed around all your life. You've been pushed around by your mother, and your father, and your sister, and your brother. And if you was married, you'd get pushed around by your wife. But in your future, the you that I see is exactly the man you always wanted to be. Now come on, boys. Won't you shake my hand? Won't you shake a poor sinner's hand? Yeah. Are you ready? Are you ready? Transformation Central. Reformation Central. Transmogrification Central. Can you feel it? You're changing, alright. I hope you're satisfied. But if you ain't, don't blame me. You can blame my friends on the other side.
You know, I wouldn't be here if I hadn't seen my soul tonight. Well, I didn't think it was my soul at first. But when it started telling me so much about how I'm only happy when listening to Simon and Garfunkel, or how I'm scared of being hit by invisible cars, well, it just sounded so much like me. So I got to it. I got tired and asked, if you can tell me one thing about myself, what would it be? And for a moment, it hesitated. Like, it was just trying to decide what juicy secret it's going to tell me. And then it sighed as long as the soul can, then hiccuped, almost as if it's excited, or drunk, or something. Then it told me with its tiny voice, like the voice of a fawn or a baby lamb, it told me, if you live through today, you'll get fired tomorrow. And if you find another job, you'll get fired from there too. And when you find the person you love, they're gonna leave you. And when you die, no one's gonna care. So what can you say? What can you say when your own soul thinks that you're a failure? And they're pretty happy about it too, almost giddy. So I started thinking, what if it's not my soul? What if it's the soul of an arch nemesis or something like that? They're just begging for you to stop fighting the fight. Then they will win by forfeit. So I said and did the only thing I can think to do. I told it, I don't need you. Then I squashed it and killed it. I guess that's why I'm down here. You know, I really thought it'd be hotter.
I don't like to hurt people. I don't enjoy hurting people. I don't like guns or bombs or electric chairs, but sometimes people just don't want to listen. so I have to use persuasion and slides. My parents, Sharon and Dave, generous, doting, or were they? All I ever wanted was a ballerina Barbie and her pretty pink tutu. My birthday, I was 10. Do you know what they got me? Malibu Barbie. That's not what I wanted. That's not who I was. I'm a ballerina Barbie. Graceful and delicate. So they had to go. My first husband, the surgeon. Coronaries, transplants all day long. Sorry about dinner, Deb. The Pope has a cold. The nerve. The nightmare. So, next to his head. My second husband, the senator. He loved his state. He loved his country. But what about Debbie? No Mercedes this year, Deb. We have to set an example. Set this! A bowling ball fell. And my late husband, Fester, the corpse, the fool, and his adorable family. They accepted me. They wanted me to be one of theirs. But did any of them love me? Really love me? So yes, I maimed, I killed, I destroyed one innocent life after another. But don't I deserve love? Anti-human being, don't I yearn and ache and shop? Don't I deserve love and jewelry?
Here, Santa Claus, huh? Ooh, I'm really scared. So you're the one everybody's talking about. You're joking. I can't believe my eyes. You're joking. You gotta be. This can't be the right guy. He's aging. He's ugly. I don't know which is worse. I might just spend a season if I don't die laughing first. This is what you believe in me. There's trouble, close pain. Prepare, pay attention now, cause I'm the burning man. And if you are shaking, listen to me. This may be the last time you hear the bully song. Whoa, whoa, whoa. It's not much to do. I just pick a snatch of that, just make it better still. You know you know the one thing, but I'm looking for some nice. A lordy boy, Santa Claus, to add a little spice. Oh, 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 oh. I'm a old lady. At least now, you will have consequences. The children are expecting me, so please come to your senses. I'm going to do my stuff. What do you want me to do? I'm going to do the best I can. You're in. You're in. You're in. You're in. You're in. absolutely boogie, and you don't go no more.
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize y'all's neighborhoods. And whosoever shall be found without the soul of getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse shell. And the foulest stench inside the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, and no mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.
It's what I do, I am the best, for my talents are renowned far and wide. When it comes to surprises in the moonlit night, I excel without ever even trying. With the slightest little effort of my ghost-like charms, I have seen grown men give out a shriek. With a wave of my hand and a well-placed bow, I have swept the very bravest off their feet. Yet year after year, it's the same routine, and I grow so weary of the sound of screams. And I, Jack, the Pumpkin King, have grown so tired of the same old thing. I'm Mr. Unlucky, and I'm known throughout England and France. And since I am dead, I can take off my head to recite Shakespearean quotations. Nor animal nor man can scream like I can with the fury of my recitations. But who here would ever understand the Pumpkin King with the skeleton brain would tire of his crime? If they only understood, he'd give it all up if he only could. Oh, there's an empty place in my heart that calls out
at me like she knows. It doesn't matter that her eyes are closed. She sees through them. She sees through me.
Shelly knows I did it, and I can feel her searching me, and I don't know where is safe. Should I leave town?
Will her soul stay here?
Do I have to join her?
Do I have to fight her from that side?
Oh God, did you see that?
Did her eyes just open?
Crickets.
It's always crickets for Ashley, my honey. Whenever I request something, crickets. You know they still do trash pickup at 6 a.m. on my block. Why do you get to sleep until 7? A mile away when I'm listening to the beeping of that garbage truck back up on our dead street before the sun even comes up? I've written 10 letters, but nothing. Just crickets. Okay, that's just my sleep. But this rock, this is a real hazard. And if it has bloody me, has blood all over my Banana Republic dress, maybe they take me seriously. Well, it's a moot point anyway. But if I don't get all this blood on me from the rock, although it's kind of related, it's actually entirely related. If the mayor had listened when I kindly asked him to remove that rock, please, I said, please remove the rock, then you wouldn't be looking at me like that, mouth wide open, and we wouldn't even be having this conversation. You're the one who told me, you told me that the man on Calvert, he fell and broke a rib on that rock, Stella. So you're not innocent either, Stella. You can't even put a cast on a broken rib. You just have to wait for it to heal, Stella. Now, you know, he could have punctured a lung once he fell on that rock, Stella. What if he had punctured a lung and broke his rib, Stella? You can die from puncturing a lung, Stella. You can die from puncturing a lung. A message needs to be sent to the authorities. I send messages. And when I send messages and the authority don't listen, it's time for a new authority. And I sent messages and the authority didn't listen, Stella. I know you were watching when I stabbed the mayor, but you won't say anything, Stella. You wouldn't want that little person on Calvert to die from puncturing a lung, would you, Stella? The mayor should have just removed the rock.
Talking to myself here, but then, Mom, I gotta ask, are you really in the ground? 'Cause I feel you all around me. Are you here, dead Mom? Dead Mom. Dead Mom. I'm tired of trying to iron out my creases. I'm a bunch of your mom. 'Cause daddy's in denial, daddy doesn't wanna feel. He wants me to smile and clap like a performing seal. Ignored him for a while, but daddy lost his mind for real. You won't believe the mess that he made.
lightning strike or drop a nuclear bomb. No more playing daddy's game. I'll go insane if things don't change. Whatever it takes to make him say your name, dead mom.
From childhood's hour, I have not been as others were. I have not seen as others saw. I could not bring my passions from a common spring. From the same source, I have not taken my sorrow. I could not awaken my heart to joy at the same tone. And all I loved alone. Then, in my childhood, in the dawn of a most stormy life was drawn from every depth of good and ill, the mystery which binds me still, from the torrent or the fountain, from the red cliff of the mountain, from the sun that round me rolled in its autumn tint of gold, from the lightning in the sky as it passed me flying by, from the thunder and the storm as the cloud that took the form. When the rest of heaven was blue, I'm a demon in my view.
The Seed in My Brain, a thriller monologue by Tara Madeau. It's this heat. I feel it in. I feel it in my face first, my head. That's the most dangerous place, isn't it? It controls everything, my brain. So when my brain is hot, then my body, it gets hot too, and it does what my brain needs to have done. I don't want to twist your wrist until I hear those little bones crackling. I just feel so hot, and it's the only thing that cools me down. Oh, you look so sad, so scared. Have you ever walked along the beach in a heat wave? Felt the sand so hot under your feet that it stings? Thousands of sizzling daggers twisting and burning and pressing, invading your body. Have you felt that? It's unbearable, isn't it? You look pained now, but this is only your shoulder out of joint. Your finger's broken. Imagine that burning pain of sun-baked knife, but in your brain, that is real pain. But if you had a bucket of ice right next to that torturous sand, and you knew it would cool down your scorching feet and you would feel right again, wouldn't you use it? Or at least you couldn't blame me for using it, could you? Don't blame me. You're the one who ignored me when I said hello. You're the one who gave me this heat in my brain. And you're the most special person of all, because you're the only one who can cool it down. That was my monologue.
My sister screams in the middle of the night. Blood, crawling screams. But I lie in bed, dreaming the mist away from the earth. And her screams penetrate them. She cries for me. She cries for someone, and there's nothing that I can do that will help. So I bring her lavender in hopes that one day it will calm her. I lie in bed and drift away. But she screams. What can I do, sister? Why are you screaming? What scares you? What scares you? One night, when the screams got too much, I got up and I kneeled on top of her. Stop screaming. stop screaming, please. And she stops. But only because she knows someone is there. She doesn't want them to know that she's here. She's quiet. My mother says that I have to stop coming to see my sister at night. But don't you hear her screams, mother? She doesn't. Only me. She's quiet. I got up. I'm dirty. From where I was kneeling on top of her grave. My sister is dead. Silent in her coffin. But she still screams.
You could use a buddy.
Don't you want a pal?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Girl, the way you see me, daddy should be me. You should stick around and kill him.
What?
Nothing. So, Lydia, don't end yourself. Defend yourself. Daddy is the one you should make. Together with a stamina and assassinate.
No.
The final point can win, but first you gotta say my name. Go ahead and jump, but that won't stop him. Here you got a solid plan, the option. I can give your daddy so much pain. All you gotta do is say my name. Girl, just say it 3 times in a row. And you won't believe how far I'll go. I'm on the bench, but coach, just put me in the game. All you gotta do is say my name.
I don't know your name.
Well, I can't say it.
How about a game of charades?
Yes, let's play it.
Two words. Second word, drink. Beverage, wine, juice. Okay, first word, bug, ant, beetle, beetlejuice.
Wow, and I'm impressed. And all you gotta do is say my name 3 times, 3 times in a row. It must be spoken, I'm broken. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, go.
Beetlejuice.
Yes.
Beetlejuice.
Yes. Oh, this is gonna be so good.
What?
I'm off for you, time's patient.
Are you any good?
You betcha, trust me, baby.
I just met ya, really, it's flattering on them.
Don't you wanna see that suffer?
I think I'd rather just show
no.
off. I may be suicidal on the field, just another bite of my mind.
Oh, you play hardball, huh? So you're tougher than you look.
I just wanna make sure I know who I'm working with.